In terms of the protocol, every entrance is to be through the main door. Side doors for bathroom, or if you have to go outside, that is how you would exit the building. When you're returning, you must come back through the main entrance. Is that understood? Is that understood? Nod. Okay, right. And of course, you know that as families, you can sit beside each other. There should be no congregating. You're supposed to be in your mask, and you're supposed to observe those guidelines as strictly as possible. So all entrance through the main door, exiting, you go through the side door. Thank you so very much.
Good afternoon, everyone. Certainly, we thank God for the privilege of communicating with Him. So therefore, at this point in time, let us all reverently stand for our opening prayer. Our heads are bowed, our eyes are closed. Our loving Heavenly Father, we thank Thee for being here with us in a special way, for all of the blessings that You have bestowed upon us. We ask Thee to forgive us of every single sin and allow us to know that Your grace empowers all of us to choose that way of escape whenever tempted. Loving Heavenly Father, we come before You this evening asking Thee to be with everyone in the ways he or she needs Thee most. And with respect to our dear graduates, allow them to know that You have afforded them the privilege of being in Your school so that they are empowered by You to live a certain lifestyle which would reflect Your law, which would reflect Your love. So please be with all of them in their decision making. Grant that they will always rely on You and not lean on their own understanding. Allow them to know that with You, when challenges come, they can still smile because You have the solution to every single problem. Be with their parents and guardians as well. Bless them accordingly. Allow them to know that You have placed them together so that they can rely on You to make decisions that will not only benefit them now, but for eternity. So, loving Heavenly Father, be with the rest of the proceedings of this evening. Allow Your will to be done. In Jesus' name, please. Amen.
Good afternoon to everyone. At this point, I would like to invite you, as you remain standing, for the national anthem of Barbados.
When this fair land was young, our brave forefathers sowed the seed from which our pride is sprung. A pride that makes no one tremble of what it has withstood, that binds our hearts from coast to coast, the pride of nationhood. We loyal sons and daughters all do hereby make it known. These fields and hills beyond recall are now our very own. We write our names on history's page with expectations great. Straight guardians of our heritage, firm craftsmen of our fate. people's sky for past 300 years. With him still on the people's side, we have no doubts or fears. A burden or worry shall go, inspired, exalted, free. And greater will our nation grow in strength and unity. We loyal sons and daughters do hereby make it known. These fields and hills beyond recall are now our very own. We write our names on history's page with expectations great. Great guardians of our heritage, firm craftsmen of our faith.
And now our school song.
By the grace of God I aspire, by the grace of God I achieve. We will persevere as he gives us strength. We'll stand firm for the cause we believe. No task is too small to be left undone. No duty so great to intimidate. He stands by my side so that I can say, I overcome by the grace of God. I overcome by the grace of God. By the grace of God I stand strong. By the grace of God I'm free. He inspires us in each endeavor to be all that he wills us to be. No task is too small to be left undone. No duty so great to intimidate. He stands by my side so that I can say, I overcome by the grace of God. I overcome by the grace of God.
You may be seated.
The church at my little quarter is pleased to be associated with the Seventh-day Adventist Secondary School in this graduation exercise 2020. We are pleased to be host of this part of the exercise, of the graduation exercise. And indeed, we declare, some of you may not know, but we've had a long association of support with the school, to the extent that we currently have about 9 of our children here at Maryland Quarter attending the secondary school as well as the primary school. We know that you had a very beautiful consecration service yesterday, and we are pleased that you've chosen Maryland Quarter, where the parents and guardians and well-wishers and supporters of the school can come to recognize the advancement of our students and also share with them in this graduation exercise. I want just to make a point that you are fortunate to be able to gather like this, because COVID-19 has continued to stretch its hand into 2020 to the point where we are almost, well, in some cases, pushed back to what happened or what was common over 50 years ago. When I left secondary school many, many years ago, over 50 years, there was no graduation exercise. You came to the end of your school career, that was your last day at school, you told your friends goodbye, and you went on your merry way. If you did well enough, you might be called back to get a certificate or a prize at speech day. But with COVID-19, I've seen cases where there's been virtual graduations with guest speakers addressing the graduates remotely. I've seen cases where principals have identified who the graduates are and then have gone house to house to hand out certificates to the students. I've seen cases where the students have been called to the schools on a particular day and teachers met them on the street just outside the gate to hand them the certificates and wish them well for the rest of the journey. But I'm saying this evening that you are fortunate that you can come in this setting and be supported by your parents, your guardians, and the school. We want then to say congratulations to all of you who are graduating. We want to continue to our prayers of support for the school, the administration, and also the staff. And we pray that God will continue to bless you real good as you continue the journey. Welcome to Maryland Quarter, and may you have a very good and productive sitting. Thank you very much.
The Honorable Colin E. Jordan, MP, Minister of Labor and Social Partnerships Relations. Pastor Adanfo Francis, President of the East Caribbean Conference of Seventh-day Adventists. Dr. Carl Doyle, Ministerial Director of the East Caribbean Conference and Pastor of the Good News Community Church. Dr. Cheryl Weeks, President of the Flodden Alumni Association and Vice Principal of the Barbados Community College. Pastors, Elder, Board of Management, Administrators, Homeschool Association, faculty and staff, parents and guardians, graduates, other stakeholders, sponsors, supporters of the Barbados SDA Secondary School, I welcome you to the 2020 commencement ceremony of the 2020 graduating class. It gives me great joy this evening to greet you on behalf of the Board of Management, the administration, the faculty and staff, and the class. I want to thank you for making it possible that our graduates can have this special moment in their life as they transition to BCC, University of the West Indies, USC, or to the working environment. I know that they have long looked forward to this occasion, and I am happy that we were able to have this program. In the normal year of things, this would have been completed since June 2021. But of course, you know, we're not in the normal situation because COVID-19 coronavirus happened. In the normal situation, our students would have completed their exams by the end, the first week of July, but they just completed them August 10. So because of the surreal new normal that we're experiencing, we're having this graduating exercise at this time. It was a joy to work with these boys and girls, to see them daily going about their business, whether it was having fun, whether it was just liming on the school compound, or seeing them in classrooms as I visited to evaluate lessons. I am so happy for them this evening that they can all be here in good health to enjoy this final step at secondary school. Yesterday we were at the Breath of Life to consecrate them to God, so that as they go out God will be with them, so that as they go out, they will make him first place in their lives. Graduates, I want to say to you, remember who started this good work in you, who has brought you to this point in time, and who will be with you as you go on your way. Remember the plans he has for your life, the plans to prosper you and to stand in Christ alone will help you to realize his purpose. We began the academic year 2019-2020 with two things. We heard that we had improved our CSET passes. We moved from 86.2 to 90.1, and that was good for us. That was the reward of the faculty and staff at our school. And then the next major beginning was to have our annual consecration teachers service, which we held. Never knowing that as we gathered to consecrate ourselves to God, that we would have had such a year as this. I must thank Dr. Cheryl Weeks, because I was in a program at the Cave Hill Church where she then informed those of us gathered there about COVID-19. At that time, it had not reached Barbados. And then I must also thank Dr. Natalie Graves, who sent information for me to share with the school about COVID-19 and what we were supposed to do to make sure that we stay safe and healthy. I want to thank God that in coming on to its impact in Barbados, that we had started our preparation under the guidance of our education director, Dr. Daphne McGlure, who got us started by making the necessary preparations for the online learning. I must give kudos to Brother Clifford Trotman from the East Caribbean Conference, who was the first person to begin instructing us in the Google platform. The staff gathered together with him and he kind of instructed us on what to do. And then I must especially thank my vice principal or deputy principal, who I call my right hand, Mr. Andrew Yearwood. I must also thank Dr. Eldon Blackman and Mrs. Stacy Cashier for the hard work they would have put in to ensure that our faculty was ready and prepared to begin term three, the Trinity term, the last term. We were able to start at the designated date for that time. Our teachers put in long hours, and the persons who I identified just now, we were up sometimes 3 o'clock, 4 o'clock. We are still up trying to get things in place so that come August 15th, we were able to orient our students and parents on the new platform for e-learning. Teachers were supposed to be on vacation, but all along, because of the July 2020 CSET exams, they were online working with the staff. And I must extend heartfelt appreciation to all the faculty for carrying our children through to their exam. The last person that would have been there would have been Mrs. Boyce, because Spanish Orals was held on August 10th. So, on vacation, but yet still working. I want to thank the parents too, and the guardians who logged on and who ensured that the students stayed to the task so that they could get their work done. I especially also want to thank our business manager, Mrs. Juliet Stricker, who working with the ancillary staff, got the school open, ready for reopening and prepared the necessary protocols so that those who had to come on campus was able to come, complete their SBAs so that they could be submitted to the CXC. I also want to give special mention to the members of the executive of the East Caribbean Conference for their support and guidance, as well as to the Board of Management for their guidance during COVID-19. We really had to work together to make sure that we do all that we possibly could to meet the challenges that we were confronted with. I again want to go back and mention those parents who in financial difficult times remember to remit their tuition fees to us so that we could have paid our staff. Thanks to you. Thanks to you, parents and guardians. Thanks to the members of the ECC, and thanks to the Board of Management. Thanks to the faculty and staff. I want to let you know how much I appreciate all your effort. And I want to thank also the class sponsors for making this evening possible. I greet you, and I trust that as we move on to the other activities that you will enjoy them. Thank you so very much.
Very pleasant. Good afternoon to everyone. The Honorable Minister of Labor and Social Partnership and Relations, members of the board of the Seventh-day Adventist Secondary School, the principal, business manager, teachers, staff, the graduation class. Could we give them a good round of applause? They are why we are here this afternoon. Other specially invited guests, pastors, platform personnel, the media and the press, ladies and gentlemen in person and on the virtual platform. I am delighted to greet you on this auspicious occasion on behalf of the administration of the East Caribbean Conference of Seventh-day Adventists, the school board, and the education director, Dr. Daphne McGlow, who is sequestered in Dominica and is watching online. But congratulations. Congratulations to the graduation class of 2020 for your outstanding performances as graduates. The administration of the conference and the education department commend the 2020 graduation class for successfully surmounting several hurdles during the 2019-2020 academic school year. So today, we celebrate your strong tenacity of purpose and rejoice with you and your family for your achievements. As you leave the secure walls of our noble institution and broaden your horizon by possibly going on to the university, please remember our tertiary institutions like USC. Or if you enter the job market, we ask you to keep your theme in focus, to infinity forever excelling. Our world needs you to continue to excel to infinity, and no boundaries should retard your progress. The new normal should give you the impetus to track new paths, to build on your experience, to explore tangible and intangible treasures, to make your world, to make our world a better place. I commend the education director for her vision and her action to have moved our schools quickly onto the virtual platform in the face of COVID, so that the school year could have gone on uninterrupted. We express gratitude to our board for being supportive and creating the policy framework for a successful school year. But our profound gratitude goes out to the school management, the principal who spoke just before me, and the business manager, the teaching staff, and the staff who, under these new circumstances, these strange circumstances and financial constraints and other hardships, gave of their best so that we not only had learning taking place, but excellencies were being achieved. Let's give them a round of applause. It was not easy. As I sat with the board and we discussed some of the issues confronting the management and the staff, the teaching staff, we recognized that they were being asked to work harder for less. And so that is why I asked you to give them a good round of applause, for they gave of their best. That being said, we also applaud the parents, members, and friends who not only stood by, but gave support, supported the effort with their resources, not excluding financial resources. Your approach, class, towards the unexpected, and all of us, the unexpected interruptions in the regular order of school signal that as a school, we are committed to excelling forever. That thought, however, raises issues of continuity in spite of whatever obstacles may come. It also raises the idea of surmounting, allowing no obstacles to hinder the progress. With God as the people's guide, we need not fear, for it was He, God, who guided this church to establish schools, so that we would not only prepare students as citizens for this life, but for the life hereafter. And so I'm happy to reaffirm that our school is destined for greatness. With Jesus at the helm of the institution, we will keep ascending the ladder of holistic success, which has no finish line. Let us all keep that as our focus of education. So once again, to the graduation class, congratulations to the graduating class of the Barbados Assembly Adventist Secondary School. Keep striving. May God bless you continually.
We shall now have a musical selection by the graduates.
But to heal the heart and not turn
Mine is a privilege to introduce to you the commencement speaker. I don't believe that I have to say much because a bio of him is in the brochure which you hold in your hand. But I would just like to add a personal touch to what is written there. I met the speaker as a youngster at the time when I pastored the Mile and a Quarter Assembly Adventist Church, where he is still a member. At that time, I found him to be a creative and promising young man. The years have passed, and the fact that the late Right Honorable Owen Arthur selected and groomed him to succeed him as the parliamentary representative of the parish of St. Peter gives you an idea of the quality, the ability, the possibilities that lie within his breast. I can only say and quote from a biblical concept, like the biblical Saul, he's head and shoulders over all of us. Therefore, it gives me great pleasure to give you the Honorable Minister of Labor, Social Partnership Relations, the Honorable Colin Thorne. Colin Jordan.
Thank you very much, Pastor Francis. And yes, in spite of how young Pastor Francis looks, when he was my pastor, I was a little boy. I just want you to put him in context. President of the East Caribbean Conference of Seventh Adventists, Pastor Danforth Francis, other members of the executive committee in the administration, departmental directors of the East Caribbean Conference of Seventh-day Adventists, those with me on the platform, members of the school board, principal, Ms. Annette Aline, teaching and non-teaching team members of the school, students of the graduating class of 2020, parents and guardians, specially invited guests, media professionals, those following on live stream, and I need to identify specifically Sister Daphne McGlure, with whom I served when I was a member of the executive committee, and to laud her for the work she has been doing. Distinguished ladies and gentlemen, all, good afternoon. You can speak even with a mask on. You just have to say good afternoon. You don't have to sing or anything like that. It is an honor, though, to be afforded the opportunity to share a few thoughts with you this afternoon, but particularly with those of the graduating class of 2020. It is a privilege to be able to do that. I'm happy that there are some members of the leadership of the church here today and also following on the live stream, because I feel the need to remind all of us of something that we already know. The work, let me begin the quote from Ellen White in the book Education, in the highest sense, the work of education and the work of redemption are one. In the highest sense. And so support for Seventh-day Adventist Christian education must both be seen and felt, so that our leaders, whether at the executive committee level, in administration, departmental directors, pastors, and at the local level, elders and church boards, must all be champions of God's system of education. It is our solemn duty. If the statement or the cliche that our children are the leaders of tomorrow, if it is not just to be what we sometimes term hot air, then we will need to be intentional in our approach to preparing them for the future. We must be prepared to invest time, our abilities and our skills, we sometimes say talents, as well as our money in them. In other words, we have to be good stewards for the development of our children. Students, no, I'm hearing, but I'm more looking for your attention. And you must pardon me because my father was a teacher, my mother was a teacher, my wife is a teacher. It is all around me. So I'm looking for your attention. But I call you to attention because I want to say to you that you look great, you look promising. Yes, you do as well. You look promising. It is because you are. And I'm saying this not just because you have been created by God, and that is preeminent. You have been created by God, so you are valuable. You mean a lot. But I'm also saying this to you because, unlike many of the rest of us, you have had to live through, as young people, something that we have not had to live through as young people. You've had to live through and been forced to live through the lockdown of a country, the inability sometimes to worship in church buildings, the inability even sometimes to go to the beach, having to go to the supermarket by surname, the physical distancing that stops you from associating in the way that you would normally want to associate and naturally want to associate. And I know that I'm talking about COVID-19. I must say, Madam Principal, that I am absolutely impressed by the cleaning regimen that I've seen here this afternoon. The protocols for churches I had some hand in preparing, and I never envisaged that they would be as complete as what I've seen today. So you are to be commended. Some of you of the graduating class experience, and you may not have been aware of it, but a global financial meltdown when you were about 4 or 5 years old. And so some of you may not even have been at primary school at the time. Most of you are now 16, some 15, maybe some 17. At a time when the world is battling the COVID-19 pandemic, I say to you this afternoon that God is making you strong for a future that you are not aware of. I have to say that again because you were distracted. God is making you strong for a future that you are not aware of, but a future that he fully understands, a future that he knows. Your theme today is an interesting one. How many of you like mathematics? A group of honest students. There are not many people who can say they like mathematics. People do mathematics, but not many people like mathematics. But infinity is a mathematical concept. And so I want to begin this phase of what I'm going to say by suggesting to you that even in subjects that you do not like, you ought to pay at least a little bit of attention. Because there are principles embedded in every subject, principles that you can use to assist you as you develop and as you grow. Principles. And the Assembly of Adventist Church is based on principles rather than actions. Principles are what guide us. But infinity is a mathematical concept, a construct, and it represents the idea that something has no end point. And so it goes on forever. It does not necessarily mean large. The emphasis is more on endless. So that if you divide 1 by 3, you get 0.33333. And that decimal has no ending. It will go on toward infinity. So it means going on forever. And that is because infinity is not a destination. Infinity is not a destination. Infinity means going on forever. The concept of destination and the concept of going on forever are opposing. So we say toward infinity, going on forever. And that concept is well known to Seventh-day Adventists. We understand God to be infinite, having no beginning, having no end. We speak in our theology of eternity past. Of the new earth, we sing, and a familiar song to many of us, Amazing Grace. But the final verse of that hymn says, when we've been there 10,000 years, bright, shining as the sun, we've no less days to sing God's praise than when we first begun. So after 10,000 years, eternity, infinity, is not reduced, endless. But students of the graduating class, let me briefly bring you back to earth for a little while. To excel or excelling speaks to being extremely good at something or to doing something better than you normally do. And you're no doubt familiar with the related words excellent and excellence. Excelling is in the English grammar a present participle. And so it means that it is something that is happening now and is also continuing. Excelling. Happening now and continuing. But I want to say to you that the desire to excel, the desire to become better, is not natural. It is not natural. Even to those who may be considered to be academically gifted, it is not natural. You don't wake up every day of your own volition and decide, I'm going to be great, I'm going to be better, with that burning desire to excel. Some of you may have heard of the second law of thermodynamics, and don't worry about the size of the word. It essentially says that anything left to itself will degenerate. Anything left to itself, it is a natural law, it is a physical law. Anything left to itself will naturally degenerate. But we know that God wants us to excel. We know that he does. Paul in Philippians 3 speaks about pressing on. He speaks about reaching forward. He speaks about pressing forward. And these are all images of moving forward, getting better, rising higher. We sing another lovely hymn which says, I'm pressing on the upward way. New heights I'm gaining every day. Still praying as I onward bound, Lord, plant my feet on higher ground. That idea, that concept of moving forward and constantly and consistently moving forward. We also know that this moving forward is not just limited to what we do on earth. And I want to share with us a relatively short quotation from The Great Controversy, from a bit of it on page 677 and a little bit on page 678, just to illustrate this idea of moving forward and connect it to infinity, endless. She says under inspiration, there, meaning in the new earth, immortal minds will contemplate with never failing the delight the wonders of creative power, the mysteries of redeeming love. She continues, the acquiring of knowledge will not weary the mind or exhaust the energies. And she says, and still, there will arise new heights to surmount, new wonders to admire, new truths to comprehend, fresh objects to call forth the powers of mind and soul and body. And then she says this. And the years of eternity, as they roll, will bring richer and still more glorious revelations of God and of Christ. So that the idea of moving forward, getting better, excelling, is not something that is related only to now, only to your lives at school, at tertiary institutions, or at work, or in retirement. It is something that God has designed to last into infinity, into eternity, to be endless, to continue. Now, I did not come this afternoon to preach a sermon, but I thought I needed to place the theme in context. Because in life, young men and young women, if you do not appreciate the context, if you do not understand the context, then you are liable to come to incorrect conclusions. And you're liable to make mistakes if you do not understand the context. Now, I said earlier that the desire to excel is not normal. And so there is effort that is required. Effort is required. There must first be a desire to want to improve, to want to excel. And then there must be the recognition that one needs assistance in moving forward. I'm waiting for you to start watching the bird. If you are to excel, if we are to excel, then there must first be a desire to want to excel, and then a recognition that one needs, that you need, and that I need, assistance. All of us need assistance from outside of ourselves. Students need prodding. And all through your work life, your school life, your parents have been prodding you, your guardians have been prodding you, your teachers have been prodding you, pushing you, sometimes confusing you. but that is because they want to see you excel. And students and young people are not the only ones who have to be prodded. Sometimes the adults like myself need even more prodding than you. Because in spite of how we look and how we get on sometimes we get lazy too. And so we need to be prodded. Something, somebody outside of us needs to help us to move forward, to help us to strive for better, to reach forward, to press forward, and to excel. I encourage you, students, young men and young women, I encourage you to appreciate when you are being prodded. I encourage you to appreciate when you are being prodded. When I was 16, I did not fully appreciate being prodded. And the reason I use the word confused just now is because that is how I felt, and that is how I feel some of you felt and feel. That the adults in your life confusing you. Don't want me to do this, want me to do work all the time. That is how I felt. I don't know if you're any different. But having had the benefit of a few years of experience, I want, even if you don't like it, I want you to appreciate the prodding and the pushing from those who have your best interests at heart. God did it for me, along with my parents. They didn't just prod, my father would use the strap too. But God also does it for us. In Philippians 2 and verse 13, one of my favorite texts, the Contemporary English Bible says, God is the one who enables you both to want and to actually live out his good purposes. Graduating class, God can do that for you as well. He wants to push you. He also wants to give you the ability to improve and to excel. There are other factors that come into play as well. You need to read widely. You need to read widely. You learn by reading. Physical books, audio books, you need to read. You will never become knowledgeable without reading. Watch good documentaries. Good documentaries. Listen to educational podcasts. I'm a little bit older than you are, and I was encouraged by my younger daughter, who is an alumni of your school, our school, but your school. She encouraged me to listen to good podcasts. So I listen to good podcasts, and I realize that we can learn a lot by listening to good podcasts. And I want to commend them to you as well. Have conversations with people who know more than you do. Have conversations with people who know more than you do. You only learn from people, well, you can learn from two sets of people. Either people who know more than you or people who have made mistakes. Have conversations with people who know more than you. Listen to people who have had more experience than you have had. And I want to be very clear to you, in the presence of your guardians and your parents, that experience is not necessarily synonymous with age. My father told me many years ago that there are some people 40 years old with 40 years of experience. And there are some people who are 40 years old with 1 year of experience 40 times. God will help you to discern those who have good experience. Listen to people who have experience. Ask them questions. And ask questions for the people who are willing to engage with you. Because I've come across lots of adults, too many, who, when me as a young person, asked probing questions, got scared. And I realized that there's still a lot of those adults around. People who believe that if you ask a question that is too deep, too tough, that either you are straying away or you want to learn too much. Have conversations with people who are prepared to engage with you and to share with you from their good experience. These things are necessary if you are to expand your mind and increase your knowledge. And that should be the aim of all of you. Excelling, excelling, excelling. There's also always, young men, young women, students of the graduating class, always room for improvement. And if we decide to, in this life and in the life to come, if we decide that there's always room for improvement, then we will continually and be forever excelling. Graduating class of 2020, congratulations on reaching a significant milestone in your growth and development. You are on a journey. You are on a journey. If you stay close to God and remain grounded in His Word, your journey will continue on forever. May you forever excel.
And now I invite the graduating class of 2020 to stand as we have a prayer of dedication. As a matter of fact, I'm going to invite everybody to stand for this special prayer of dedication. We're going to ask our gentlemen to remove your headpieces for now. The ladies, that's fine. We are about to pray. Let us bow our heads for prayer. Eternal God, most wonderful Father, we are assembled, Lord, in the cool of this evening to celebrate with this class, graduating class of 2020. Celebrate, Lord, your leading in their lives up to this point. We pause to say thank you for all you've done and will continue to do in and through them. We thank you that at this point, Lord, they're about to transition to higher academic pursuits or even to the labor market. We thank you for helping them to remember that your plan for them is to prosper them, to give them an expected end. You said in your word, and as part of their theme in the text, that your thoughts for them are thoughts of peace, to give them a future and to give them hope. And so this afternoon they stand in your presence, not sure of what the future holds, but confident that with you they can be and will be successful. And so, O Heavenly Father, I pray that as they launch out from here into the unknown, I pray that you will help them not only to become good citizens of our nation, but because of Christ in their lives, as they seek you first, may they become candidates for immortality. Again, I just ask that you will bless their endeavors. Again, I pray, O God, that you will take them as their desire to infinity. We long for that time when our Lord shall return and all that confuses us here on this earth will be no more. We take this opportunity also, Lord, to thank you for our school, our principal and faculty and staff, for the exec committee and the board of management. We thank you also, Lord, for the fact that you have ordained this school to train men and women, boys, men and women, boys and girls, to not only live for success, but live one day to see you when you come the second time. So, Father, into your hands, I just want to commit all of these students, graduates of the class of 2020. Embrace them with your power. Grant them your Holy Spirit to guide and to direct and to protect their lives. And whatever may be their pursuits for the future, may they seek first the kingdom of God and his righteousness. And we are sure that all the desires of their hearts you will grant to them. So Heavenly Father, again, I commit this class and the parents and the guardians and everyone into your hands. May your blessing again be with them as they chart their course for the future. And when all is said and done, I pray, dear God, that when our Lord returns in glory, these students and their parents and significant others, we all will be ready to spend eternity with Jesus. Hear and answer our prayer as we dedicate these students to your care in Jesus' name. Amen. Amen. Be seated.
Good evening, everyone. Come on, you can do better than that. Good evening, everyone. Graduates, it's at this time that you will receive your certificate to prove that you have completed 5 years of secondary education. I am going to ask you to stand by rows. When I call your name, you will proceed to the podium from this side. Come around to the table, receive your certificate and token. Pause for your picture and go back this way. Each row will remain standing until all persons in that row have returned to their position. Then I will indicate when you can sit. Is that understood by all? Okay, we'll proceed. Will the front row please stand? Maya Ali. Joshua Archer. Jonathan Brown.
Thank you.
Jones. Annabelle Sabele. Be seated. Would the third row please stand? Azari Sobers. Walker. Walker. All the graduates to stand at this time. And I'm going to ask you parents to give them a round of applause. Congratulations. Thank you.
I want to congratulate each and every one of you for, you know, reaching this milestone in life. And I will ask that as you go forward, you go with God. Whatever you aspire to do, Proverbs 3:5-6 says, He will grant you the desire of your heart. So at this time, congratulations. You may be seated. We shall now have a special of an item of special music by Gabrielle Murray and Kyoja Watson.
Much faster than the gleam of an eye, the light it will flash, and He'll split the sky. Nobody knows the day or the time.
We shall now have a tribute to parents, and that will be followed by a tribute to the teachers.
Good evening, parents, guardians, well-wishers, faculty, distinguished guests. The pleasure is mine to share a tribute, thanking the parents for all they have done for us over the years. I was given something to say, but I want to divert from that, give another perspective on parents. From the time we were born, parents were already making decisions for us. For some, they made the decision to give us Christian education for 12 years, and for some, it was 5. Some of us were happy with the decision. I personally was not fascinated by the idea, but after attending the school, we've all grown physically, socially, and very much so spiritually. Coming through the school, we've all got through it thanks to parents alongside teachers for all their support at sports, school events, and especially in our studies, which I know parents like to be a little overboard in helping us. We also like to thank you all for all your support, caring, believing in us. I'd also like to thank all the parents for giving me such a special and unique set of classmates to graduate with. I'd like to say thank you to all the parents that sent their kids over from the primary school to graduate secondary school with me, because we have created arguably the best set of footballers to pass through the school. So basically, I just want to say thank you for all you've done for us in pushing us forward, forever excelling.
Family and friends, and to all who may be viewing this graduation of 2020, we thank you sincerely. Parents, you have entrusted the Barbados 7th Adventist School to guide, lean, and wean your child into the path that God has for them. Sometimes we as children wane and become weak in decision-making and may fall into peer pressure. However, with teachers who are innate, assiduous, and platonic, we have no choice but to stand resolute, firm, and unwavering in decision-making. I can give you a plethora of information, but I don't want to bore you. However, I want to inculcate this into your minds. In this world we live in, there will be turbulent times, and we don't want our young people to fall into the hands of Satan. That's why the Barbados 7th Adventist Secondary School is here to cushion most of our faults with the help of teachers. Parents, we need you. Our lives are like steps. We go higher and higher with each climb, and we cannot do it without, most of all, God, and second in line, you, the parents. Parents, it's not about you just collecting or dropping off your children. It's about the relationship you have with them. Do they talk to you? Do you talk to them? You know, that conversation sometime in real life you may have to have with your son or daughter. A father telling his daughter, get an education, put everything afterward. A mother telling her son, choose your friends wisely. These are the things, parents, you have done for us and are continuing to do. Parents and guardians, we thank you for thank you today for helping us through this rough stage and many stages of our lives. We ask that you continually help us with the grace of God. However, there is the number one teacher that I really want to thank today. She is a mother of 4 children, 2 boys and 2 girls, a wife, a teacher, and a student of the Early Student Teachers College. And yes, I know right now she may be talking, but Miss Cashier, I would like to thank you very much for really taking us through this school year, because if it wasn't for you, most of us, we wouldn't have done it. And you have been a mother to some of us. So parents and teachers, we really want to thank you, and we ask that you may have God's richest blessings. Thank you, and do enjoy the rest of the proceedings. Elder Colin, as I'm accustomed to calling you, on the behalf of the administration and staff, parents, graduates, and all those watching online, I would like to thank you for presenting that wonderful speech to us and giving us the encouragement that we need to continue on with our lives. Thank you very much.
Protocol having already been established, ladies and gentlemen, parents and guardians, well-wishers online, good afternoon. All right. The distinct privilege is mine to present this year's valedictorian address on behalf of the class of 2020. Graduates, we made it. Think about how far we have come. Individually and as a class. Looking back to first form, it seems like it was just yesterday. Well, it was only 432,000 minutes, 7,200 hours, 1,200 days, 240 weeks, 15 terms, or simply put, 5 long years. 5 long years ago that the class of 2020 started its journey on the hallowed grounds of a heritage site called Abingdon, but affectionately known by thousands of students and staff, past and present, as the Barbados Seventh-day Adventist Secondary School, the best school in Barbados. Attending this great school was not an obligation. It was a spiritual privilege, a gift from God, passed on to us through loving parents and consecrated teachers. A gift that we cherished for 5 unforgettable years, and today I am honored to share how that gift was unwrapped and appreciated as the years went by. Well, every parent knows that young children judge the value of a gift by how large or small it is. As many would say, the bigger, the better, right? This kind of describes the huge expectations that we had of secondary school. In class 4, everyone knew who called the shots. But once again, we were the newbies on the block. And we're not allowed to forget it, at least the boys. Nearly every single one of us had to be dodging head slaps and were many times left wondering what on earth were our parents thinking when they sent us to school with skinheads. As for the teachers, if they said walk, we act so far. If they said talk, we act so much. And if they said run, we act so fast. Take for example, on the first day we entered our class, we were sternly warned. When the bell rings to end lunch, make sure you are by the line before it gets there. If not, you will have detention at lunch for the rest of the week. And to drive it all home, we would hear, "This is not a threat, it is a promise." So you could imagine the panic that set in when we were still on the field playing football after the bell had rang and looked up and saw our teacher coming down the stairs. Every boy, from the fattest to the smallest man, sprinted through the school just to get to the line before Mrs. Rock. I don't have to tell you what happened when it didn't work. But what I do know is that it helped us to become more responsible and punctual students, and for some of us, even faster athletes. Thank you, Mrs. Rock. When summer vacation had ended, and we stepped through that gate again, we were ready to take on second form. To the teachers and older students, we may have looked much the same, but we certainly felt bigger and dare anyone tell us differently. We had to learn to pick and choose as our world got smaller. though not any less complicated. We were no longer the newbies on the block. Our socks got lower and our skirts got shorter. We were finally free to roam, or at least so we thought. But with this so-called freedom, we became more carefree. How many parents could remember the many inked up pants, lost school books, caked out shoes, and the list goes on? Playing at lunch was more important than actually eating our lunch. So much so that many of us threw away part of our food to get more time to play. But some forgot to dump it. Like the boy who left the tuna sandwich in his desk over the whole weekend, only to return and find hundreds of maggots crawling out the desk and onto the floor. Within seconds, almost all of the girls were on top of chairs and tables, screaming as if death had flashed before their eyes. Well, sad to say, that boy was me. With first and second form behind us, there was no doubt in our minds that we were now becoming young men and women. Well, that is what our bodies began to tell us. Voices began to crack, I guess mine didn't crack yet, you know, but, and lines began to curve. Not only were we changing physically, but we were growing intellectually and emotionally. Play was moving to the back burner, and work and friends, in quotation marks, were taking its place. We got to choose additional subjects to lay the foundation for our senior school. It was then that our attitude towards work got more serious, because we dreaded the idea of staying down in third form and being called cakey generals. Not only was work becoming more important to us, but our appearance as well. With hormones raging and passion surging, came the first girlfriend and the first boyfriend, then the second, and then the third. But then, to realize, none will last forever. Then senior school came, and out went the junior immaturity. These were the days of the boys being excited to be in long pants, and the longing of the girls to wear skirt and blouse, which was being debated from the time we were in first form. And then, finally, they got it in fifth form. Y'all should clap for that. By this time, secondary education was losing its fluff and flair. With the increased workload, tunnel vision set in, and our focus became more refined as we prepared for CXC exams. With more of us getting bigger and better cell phones, and some finally getting their first, the impact of social media on our study time began to pose a challenge. But thanks to persistent and at times annoying parents and persevering teachers, we soon realized that WhatsApp and IG were not CXCs. And this saying was echoed. Finish it with me, class. I hustling, Lord. I hustling, Lord. I got no time to. Right. But who would have expected COVID to come to school and bring with him the cancellation of our final sports day, in-class teaching, and the postponement of CXC exams? Now the new normal was Google Classroom and Zoom in your bedroom. And to think that with the start of exams, we would get a break, all we got was face masks put on and sanitizer spray on. Well, in all of this, we have learned great lessons. One, not to procrastinate, because you never know what could happen. And two, appreciate what you have before time makes you appreciate what you had. Over these 5 years, there was a lot for the class of 2020 to be thankful for. The great memories we shared and the lasting friendships built together as a class. All the class parties, the time we sat and talked about the most random stuff, playing football with Pastor Blackman on the evenings, the karaoke sessions, and even the egg throwing as we finally aborted our egg babies, which we had to take care of for a week as part of our Bible class. And how could we forget the heated football arguments among the boys and Mr. Bartlett about which team was the best? Sir, it literally took almost our entire secondary school life before Arsenal could win another title. Well, I guess as a Barca fan, I can't really say much, but Where would we be today without all staff and teachers who tirelessly imparted their knowledge, offered their guidance, and shared their witness with us students? The following quote fittingly describes your role in our lives. A teacher plants the seeds of knowledge, sprinkles them with love, and patiently nurtures their growth to produce tomorrow's great dreams. We thank you sincerely for pushing us to be the best we can be and motivating us to reach our full potential. Give yourselves a clap. As stated earlier, God passed on to us the gift of Christian education through loving parents, but today we want to say that to us, you parents are special gifts from God. We thank you from the depths of our hearts for first of all bringing us into this world and raising us to be the young men and women we are today. We thank you for making the sacrifice to send us to this school, at times not knowing where the money would come from. Your unconditional commitment is unmatched, even though at times we behave as though we don't deserve it. On behalf of the class of 2020, moms, dads, and guardians, I say thank you. And how could we forget those relatives and friends viewing online who would have loved to be here? We thank you also for the love and support you have given to us. Graduates, we literally started from the bottom, and now we are here. You are all destined for greatness. William Shakespeare once said, "Some achieve greatness, and some have greatness thrust upon them." In life, we cannot always count on being born great, but always remember the opportunity to achieve greatness is within our grasp. Each and every one of you has the potential to change the world. You have all grown into powerful and intellectual individuals who can make a massive footprint on this world. Tables turn, bridges burn, you live and learn. And oftentimes, it's the journey that teaches you about your destination. So as we part ways, equipped with valuable knowledge, we will embark on a life to be filled with obstacles and challenges. As the great Michael Jordan once said, obstacles don't have to stop you. If you run into a wall, don't turn around and give up. Figure out how to climb it, go through it, or work around it. Fellow graduates, I ask that you chase your dreams, work hard, and make sacrifices if you want to reach it to the top. As Henry Wadsworth's poem says, "The heights by great men reached and kept were not attained by sudden flight, but they while their companions slept were toiling upwards in the night." In this way, we can truly live the theme to infinity, forever excelling. As I close, I encourage you students to keep your eyes on the prize and never give up. Winners never quit and quitters never win. And most importantly, keep God at the center of your lives and seek his guidance in everything that you do. Graduates, be phenomenal or be forgotten. Congratulations, class of 2020.
Okay, that was our valedictorian, Akiva Cumberbatch. Let's have another round of applause for him. And let's welcome now our salutatorian, Raquel Walcott.
Minister of Labor and Social Partnership Relations, the Honorable Colin Jordan, President of the East Caribbean Conference of the Adventist, Mr. Danforth Francis, Principal of the Barbados of the Adventist Secondary School, Ms. Anna Aline, members of the Board of Management, Home and School Association, Alumni Association, teaching and non-teaching staff, specially invited guests, parents and guardians, fellow graduates, ladies and gentlemen, good evening. And thank you for gracing us with your presence on this auspicious occasion. Undeniably, this journey has been a resounding success because of your invaluable contributions. As a salutatorian, I deem it a great honor and privilege to propose a vote of thanks on behalf of this year's graduating class. First and foremost, I sincerely express gratitude to our Heavenly Pilot God, who guided, protected, and sustained us during the past 5 years. He will not only be the pilot for this flight, but for every flight until our final destination, heaven. We are indebted to him for reaching this great milestone in our lives. He deserves all the glory and praise. To the pastors and members of both the Breath of Life and on the Quarter of Seventh-day Adventist churches, we wish to thank you for so willingly hosting our consecration service and graduation ceremony. May God continue to bless you abundantly. Special thanks to Mr. Roger Williams, who was very accommodating, and the deaconesses who facilitated the rehearsal, along with the media teams who ably helped us stream our services to our loved ones who couldn't be here with us this evening. I am sure you will concur that our keynote speakers for the weekend were aptly chosen. I heartily convey thanks to them for their enlightening words. Pastor Jimmy Blackman, by God's grace, we will fulfill our purpose, be optimistic, and remember the promise. The quotation, "That discussion is above your pay grade," will be forever etched in our memories. Honorable Mr. Colin Jordan, we thank you for reminding us that infinity is not a destination, but it goes on forever, and that God is infinite. He has no beginning or end. That we should endeavor to excel, even though it isn't natural, all things are possible. That moving forward isn't limited to what we have done on earth, whether at school or at work, but it's something God has designed for now and the future, and it has and will never stop. And reminding us to excel, that there must be a desire to be better and to improve, but to also recognize we need assistance along the way. The journey, I would like to take you on a journey. On board the BSDA 2020, it was filled with mixed experiences and wonderful memories. Thankfully, we have been fortunate enough to be supported by a dedicated and motivated crew. Parents and guardians, you have been the best co-pilots ever. Your love, patience, and constant encouragement can never be underestimated. Even when we experienced turbulence during this COVID-19 pandemic, you stressed the importance of perseverance in reaching our destination. We will always be appreciative of all that you have done. To our beloved principal, teaching and non-teaching staff, who were the flight attendants of this noble institution, we acknowledge you for navigating our behaviors, imparting your knowledge, providing mentorship, and inspire us to be well-rounded students. It is my prayer that you will continue to mold minds for the future and prepare individuals for God's kingdom. I must mention our deep sense of appreciation for the graduation committee and sponsors. In light of the circumstances, your planning was strategic and your efforts must be commended. Admittedly, the journey sped as fast as a Concorde, and it seemed as though the pressure was weighing in on me at times. But my fellow passengers made it worthwhile. When we experienced the air pockets and the exhaustion of exam preparation, we fastened our seatbelts and leaned on each other. We stuck together like a family. And today, graduates, we made it! Woo! You did it, guys. We did it. Today, we have taxied on this runway, but this is not our final destination. We are merely in transit. Soon, we will board different flights and pursue our own personal goals. As I bid you farewell, I implore you to maintain your relationship with God. Accept that change is a part of life and learn to adapt to it. My Auntie Maggie told me that when they first came to this school. In addition, be respectful at all times. Keep on striving, even in difficult moments. Give it back to your school where possible and be grateful for everything. Remain positive and prepare to soar to new heights and never forget your boarding pass. Proverbs 3, 5, and 6. Trust in the Lord with all thy heart, and lean not unto thy own understanding. In all thy ways acknowledge him, and he will direct thy paths. Finally, here is a simple yet profound quote by Michael Josephson. Take pride in how far you've come. Have faith in how far you can go, but don't forget to enjoy the journey. Congratulations, class of 2020. Best wishes in all your endeavors. And as you are prepared to board this new flight, remember our motto. You remember our motto, guys? What is it, guys? Supera de gracia, I overcome by the grace of God. Graduates, ladies and gentlemen, I thank you.
Honorable Minister Jordan, President of the East Caribbean Conference of Seventh-day Adventists, Pastor Danford Francis, Principal Annette Aline, parents, guardians, other specially invited guests, ladies and gentlemen, graduates. I am indeed delighted to welcome you to the Alumni Association. You are now members. You do not have to fill a form. You are members of the association. Let me say that this association, the Flodden Abingdon Alumni Association, is the best association on the island of Barbados and perhaps even beyond. The most active, the most involved, the most giving. And you are now members of that association. I also want to congratulate you on behalf of the members of the executive of the association and to say to you that you were indeed very fortunate to have traversed the best school on the island of Barbados. Sorry, Minister Jordan, but it is the best school. And we want to welcome you, we want to embrace you, and we want you to know that one of our goals is that of networking. And what we mean is that this school has produced all kinds of individuals. And it means that we are here for you. If you want to find a doctor, you can find one that came from this school. If you want to find a farmer, a teacher, a nurse, a mason, an engineer at NASA, whatever you want to find, the best neurosurgeons, whoever you want to find, you can find them among this group of illustrious persons who traverse the walls of the Barbados Seventh-day Adventist Secondary School. And so you are now among and within the ranks of a group of very distinguished and powerful individuals. And so I want to welcome you to the association. We want to encourage you. We are online. I know that younger people are into social media. You can find us online. You can join us in our various activities. But more importantly, we want you to be part of that cadre of persons who are giving back to your alma mater, giving back to the school. And that is our primary function, to give back to the school. So again, I want to say to you, welcome to the Alumni Association. Congratulations on having reached this far. And I want to wish you well as you continue in your journey. Remember, as Minister said, this is really about infinity. And you never really reach the ultimate. So I want you to remember that this is only the beginning of your journey. You have so much further to go. And please ensure that you use your time wisely and do what you know that you have the power and the ability within yourselves to do with the help of God and with all your parents, your guardians, your well-wishers, and your friends, you will continue to succeed. Congratulations again, and God bless you all.
Let us pray. Eternal God and Father, in the name of Jesus, we are so thankful for your mercies. We have experienced them new again every morning. Great indeed is and has always been and forever will be thy faithfulness unto us. Father God, we are not deserving of your love and mercy, but we are thankful that despite of who we are, you are a loving, tender, caring, compassionate, and kind Father, one who provides for us even when we don't know we have a need. You've been more than wonderful to us, Lord. You have kept us, you have preserved us, even through these times when there is so much uncertainty. You have allowed us as a school to be able to have our graduation ceremony. For this, Lord, we are thankful. We're thankful for all those who took part, all those who shared their experiences and their expertise. We're thankful to the parents for their cooperation. We're thankful to the students, Lord, for their willingness, for their obedience. Father God, it is only because of you that this evening's program was possible, and we want to say thank you. Thank you for traveling mercies. You brought us here all safely. Thank you that everything went well. It was all planned well, and it was executed well. Lord God, now we ask that your presence will continue to be with us, that you will watch over us, because we cannot watch and we cannot take care of ourselves. All that we have and all that we are and all that we desire to be rests solely in your hands. So, Father God, we commit these 44 students, 20 girls, 24 boys, into your care. We ask, God, that you will cover them with your righteousness, that your peace will rest upon them. Teach them, Lord, continually to be kind, to be thoughtful, to be caring. Help them, Lord, as they leave the Barbados Seventh-day Adventist School, to remember everything that we have tried to instill within them. Help them, Lord, to never forget the path that they have walked so far, so that it can help guide them in the path that they will continue on from today. Whether they go to sixth form, whether they go to college, whether they go to a training institution, no matter what they do, if they remain at home and do online studies or their work, whatever they do, Lord, I pray in the name of Jesus that you will give them complete success. Lord, and when they have been successful, help them to remember to give you thanks, because it is only from you. So, Lord, take care of them as they prepare to take their next step. Be with their parents. May you provide for them every day. And help our young people to be always thankful no matter what they have. Not to look at others and to compare themselves with others, but help them to be thankful for what their parents can provide. And to work hard if they want to achieve more, by God's grace, they can. So, Lord, again, thank you for this evening. Thank you for a wonderful ceremony. Thank you for everything that was done. If we fail in asking anything, O Lord God, fail not to grant it, because we ask it even in our mortal selves. We have our frailties and we may forget. But we give you all the glory, all the honor, and all the praise. And again, Lord, thank you for the graduating class of 2020. May they continue to excel and may they continue to do well. And when Jesus comes, I pray that all of us will hear, "Well done," and may we all be ushered into the eternal joys. We give you our hearts, our lives, and we ask you, Lord, to take care of us from here on, even into eternity, we pray, in no other name but Jesus' name. Amen.